Hey guys, how are you? It's a little lab we got set up here. We've got the PTZ Optics controller for the PTZ Optics cameras with tally set up with them there. Those are 320s. What I want to do is that iPad there, I want to make into a wireless confidence monitor, or I want to do a picture-in-picture with that. So I need something on an iPad. I mean, it's great. It's got the tally system that works. That's kind of a cool thing, but I need to get that live on there to show, you know, the face stuff. And here we've got another one with that. We've got the Atomos here, 4K recorders, and then we have external transcoders here, external encoders that are sending out, because I don't use the machines to actually send out, and I'll show you why. Each of the machines here is running two complete sets of software and two completes there. You can see me now in there with all the other camera angles I have here, which I'm switching here. I'm using that and that there. So here we go here. Here's another angle here. And here's another angle here. Sorry for the funny looking guy, but that's just the way it is. So that's one set of software, and we're running it internally on the same box, another set, and we're only at 50%. So I mean, that's not bad considering I've got like six or eight inputs on vMix, running all sorts of wired stuff, running a lot of NDI back and forth between and between there and between that machine there to here. Yeah, it's amazing. So I find that if I don't put the processing through the machine and put them through this here that's sending directly to live stream. So I'm using these. These are the little live stream encoders. You can get them used for about $100. Right in there, the LS100s is what those are. Here's another one, and here's a backup pro that's used to send somewhere else. I'll do a combination feed, and I send this one goes overseas to a TV station that I know. So this is our Ubiquiti. Totally full now, 16 port PoE, and I have another one in the back of the box here because it's only half. So on the back side I have another one. I've got a Zoom controller down here for my audio, 8 ports in. And look at this, that's a Mevo. Not too many people can say that Mevo is hooked up, but what I do is I hook it up through live stream. And there it is, NDI'd over. So it's just like having it onto vMix. So that's how you get your VMOs connected to vMix. Here's another server setup that I have here that's running this machine here. Running through the vMix controller, and I'm running two separate systems again. And I'm bringing another feed into this machine from here, from this machine, NDI'd over to here. And then I'm running a whole bunch of inputs with that. So that's running separately and streaming out. As you can see, that's streaming out. And I'm also using live stream here as a final result of what I do over here. But that's streaming with different call signs and everything here, through here. And this is going out to somewhere else. It's just an entertainment show that I have on the cancer show that I fade back and forth between. I mean, it's, you know, it's just something, whatever. Now I'm doing the cancer thing. So you see, this is where I do the inputs and all the work on and come out to here. And this one is streaming over there. That's been live for 4 hours. So yeah, and we're running at, with doing all that on the machine, we're running about 50%. That's not much considering what we're doing here. You know, we're doing a whole bunch of things. This is just an operation on one of our patients, and then we're back to the show. So yeah, that's what we do. And this is some of the lights we're running. We're running the I don't even have the green screen light on. We're running the Rolo lights. These are very cool, color balanced at daylight Rolo lights. They roll up, so they're very small. They connect back and forth between. This is the gear that you've seen before. This is some of the stuff that we take on the road that we're bundling up, that getting ready for February, because we go back on the road. This is where all the servers go, to vMix servers. This is all the cables, SDIs. I have two more of these cases. These are the Sony 350 broadcast cameras that we have three. Then we have a set of the FS7s. We got a bunch of the RoboCams that are from you guys, PTZ Optics. Just different stuff. We got map boxes. Got a bunch of the GoPros in there, rig parts, wireless cams. They're kind of cool. We've got a set of anamorphic lenses. This is the Atomos box, streaming gear. This carries all our Teradek gear that you haven't seen yet. There's 15 Teradeks in there. The audio gear, Blackmagic camera down there, and a bunch of stuff. So if we go to the back here, what we're doing is nothing really different. We do have some intricate wiring here and power stuff that we need to fix up, but that's what we do there. There's an audio in feed taking it, and that's how we're mounting all this stuff. We're mounting it with grap-ons here that go in, and they have a kind of a nano arm on here that can bend in any angle that you want, right? So that's kind of like what happens there, holding the arm there. And it goes on to the light stand, which is going up. Right here we have a C stand. This is a little different stand. It's pretty heavy duty, where you can have spuds coming out going on to the lights. This is kind of not consumer stuff. This is all the stuff we use. And again, another clamp on here that then goes out to the arm to hold the other light. And we're using a Cardellini. This is a Cardellini. This goes out to about that big of a clamp. We can get about a 7-inch round pole around here, and this just spins and tightens up. Gives me a plug to work with that I can mount on some of my rigging gear here to put your stuff on. It can do a bunch of stuff. It's actually also holding up some of the table that we got here. So these are very handy. And this here is a light that we're just using to light up the green screen. This is a key screen. This is a really good screen. This is some of the best stuff. So anyways, there you go, what we do. Thought you might like to see the stuff. This is a lab we got set up. We're designing the setup for this year coming up. So this is what it's going to look like for our layout for each of the shows. We'll have four of those, these setups right here. So there'll be eight. There'll be eight of the Atomos. So there's going to be four cases here that goes with us for eight ports of recording at 4K. And transcoding. And also the other thing they do, which is kind of very cool, this is all our footage too. If I go to here and I put on the scopes, what I can do is I've just now overlaid the scopes over the top here, so you can see where the blues, the greens, and the reds are. And I can also set it for waveforms, so I can see exposures live. That's why that the Atomoses are very, very cool. There's also focusing in here, where it'll all turn blue. Focus peaking line, so I can tell my people if they're in focus or not. Here, I'll turn off the focus peaking. See? Now I put the focus peaking on. Anything in blue is all in focus. There you go. It's off. So yeah, these are kind of cool things. We use them a lot, and we're sponsored by them. And they're... They kind of make our stuff really look good, hooked up with your stuff. We're using these as actual monitors when we go to the shows for your PTZ Optics. So our person will be sitting in a truck, or in this case, this is our setup here. So this will be in the back of a truck, where it'll be the same setup right here. It'll be a truck. I'll have my person with PTZ Optics sitting next to me controlling this. I'll be in here calling and switching, and my guys will be outside working their asses on. So there you go. This is our chemo show, Blues for Christmas. That's my ugly mug. That's my ugly mug. This is the Rock and Roll Sherpa show underneath here. This is, I don't even know who that is. That's Rockin' River a couple years ago. It's like 40, 50,000 there at that show. And that's another blues show there. So Anyways, peace out.
Let's implement some NDI in this puppy. That's what I'm wanting to do.